Today we're going to talk about how to install the MKS Robin Nano version 2.0 with the TMC 2209 in UART mode. So I'm going to show you a close-up of the actual stepper. So I'm going to zoom in over here. As you can see, the stepper has a bunch of writing on it. The bottom left-hand corner of the stepper, what you'll see is EN. That's making reference to this pin over here. Now, the thing that you need to know is on the back of your board, which I'll show you right now, or the front of your board, pardon me, is that the enable pin is actually located right here for the X stepper, here for the Y stepper, here for the Z stepper, here for E0, and here for E1. So what we need to know is what jumper we need to set on this board in order to use UART mode for the TMC 2209. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the browser for a moment. And inside the browser, we have the GitHub page for MakerBase. I'll put a link in the description for your convenience. And just so you know, MakerBase has supplied me with both the MKS TMC 2209 and also the MKS Robin Nano version 2.0 for this tutorial. But I will place Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. So to configure this, we need to know what our jumper settings are going to be. And down here, they have the UART mode that we need. The jumper is referred to right here. Between these two, they're saying equal, and that means the jumper. So to set this up, we'll go back to our workbench for a moment. We'll take a jumper and we'll place it where they said to place it. So it's right there. I'm going to push that down. And seeing how we know how to orient this board, as they've marked it green on one side, black on the other, we're going to install it that way. So I'm going to use the one with the cooling fin just in case, so that it will cool itself by wicking away the heat. Now, keep in mind when you do this, you're using these, you should use fans on your stepper drivers, keep them cool. The other thing that you want to keep in mind is that the voltage of the integrated circuit is set to 3.3 volts according to what they have on their website. So unfortunately, we can't load this directly through USB at the moment. So I'm going to pop out the actual drive and I'm going to connect it to a USB drive that we can plug into our computer. I'm going to plug that in there and I'm going to plug this into my computer. Now for wiring, I want to show you this real quick. Over here, what I've done is I've actually set this up with markings on it for voltage and ground. Then I've applied ferrule connectors so that the wiring bundles stay fine and they don't fray and cause a short circuit. This is the safest way to actually wire your printer. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to stick this in here and then tighten down these terminals. So for the moment, it's going to remain unplugged, but at least we have it configured for the power supply. So now we're going to go over to Marlin and actually configure it in VS Code. So inside VS Code, what we're going to do is first we're going to go over to Explorer. Then we're going to say open folder. Then we're going to go to downloads. And I've already extracted the download for Marlin 2.0. So I'm going to open that up. Then I'm going to go to the next folder. Then I'm going to say select folder. Inside here, in order to configure the motherboard, what we need to do is go to the Marlin folder, the source folder, the core folder, and then boards.h. Then inside here, we're going to search on Robin. And we're looking for the Nano V2. So we're going to copy that. We're then going to close the core folder, the source folder, and go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, we're going to search on motherboard. And the current default configuration is ramps. We're going to paste over that. Then I'm going to scroll up, and I'm actually going to change the serial port to 3. And then I'm going to search on our steppers, which is the A4988. And inside here, I'm going to remove the comment so we can use our X stepper. And I'm going to find the TMC2209. I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to paste it over the A4988. And then I'm going to show you how to set this up over here. So down here, we have default access steps per unit. Currently, it's 80, but this is also tied to a setting on the configuration advanced. So I'm going to click on this for a moment, and I'm going to search on 800. Then I'm going to move all the way down to where our X current is set. And the value that we're interested in right now is 16. That is tied to our configuration.h. So if we were to change this to 160 to double the resolution, we'd then have to change this to 32. So I'll show you another example. We'll take the 160 and change it to 320. That means that we have to change it over here to 64. And if we change this to 128, that means that we need to change this value to 640. So that increases the resolution. Next, I need to show you inverting. So inside here, I'm going to search on invert. And normally, what I would tell you to do is actually switch this to whatever you're using. But in this case, because we're using sensorless homing in this case, we're going to have to check our board to make sure that we have the jumper set for the X stepper for sensorless homing. So to do that, what we're going to have to do is go over to our board for a moment and make sure that we have that set. I may already have it in there, but I'll show you what it looks like. So over here is our jumper. I'll pull this out. That needs to be on in order to use sensorless homing. I'm going to place this back down in here. Push that down. And that is what we need to make sure is set up. So it's either going to go left or right, based on the settings in VS Code. So as you can see right here, if you want it to go right or left, you're going to either have to change it to true or false. So the other way that you can do it is actually reverse your DuPont connector 180 degrees. And I'll show you that in a moment because I still don't have it connected. So next thing that we need to do is set up our environment. So we need to go over configuration.h. I want to actually turn on debugging first. So we're going to search on TMC underscore debug. And we're going to remove the comment for monitor driver status. Then we're going to search on it again so that we can get the G code to use to monitor it, which is TMC debug. It's M122. And then we also want to set up sensorless homing. So we're going to search on sensorless, and it's actually up one, and right here is how we enable it. So we need to remove the comment in order to set that up. The other thing we need to do is change this value because this is for spy. So our range is right here for TMC. So the optimal range that I found is 125, seems to work well enough. So we're going to do that. Now, there is something you can do for sensorless homing for homing bump. You can actually change this so that the offset after it homes backs off. There's a bunch of different settings for this already, but you can do it for sensorless homing right here. So you could exaggerate this number for your X and make it 20 millimeters, and it would then back off. So that's what I'm going to do for the moment, just so you can see the functionality of this. So it'll go to the end of the access bump and then back off 20 millimeters if the measurements are correct. So now that we have that set, we're going to go to platformio.ini. We have to search on Robin underscore nano. And here's the actual configuration that we need to copy. So I'm going to copy that. That's going to be our environment. So I'm going to go back up to the top. I'm then going to change our current default environment for the Mega 2560 by pasting it right here. And that should be set. So we're going to clean to make sure that we don't have a build in the way. And then we're going to build with a checkbox. Then we'll copy the firmware over manually to the SD drive. Now, this may take a few moments to compile, compiling a lot of files. And it's moving it to our .pio folder, which is right here. So once this is complete, we're going to click on our .pi folder, .pio, pardon me. Then we're going to go to our build folder, our MKS Nano folder, right-click, say Reveal and Explorer. We're going to open that folder. We're going to find not firmware.bin, but we're going to have to use the Robin underscore nano 35. So we're going to right click and we're going to send that to our USB drive. This may take a second depending upon the USB drive. There also might be an issue with the USB drive, so we can verify it by going over here. And it looks like we copied the correct thing over because the previous build changes to all capital letters and then ends in DUR for current. So now that we have that done, we're going to remove it from the computer. And then we're going to go back over to our desktop. Now, on our desktop, we have a couple of things we have to do. So I'm going to pop out the drive, going to place it inside the Nano or the Robin Nano. We need to connect the actual connection over here for our stepper driver. So we have X, Y, Z, E0, and E1. We have the power connected, so we're good there. Our jumper is set to direct power, we hope. So I'm going to connect this first. It may load the firmware for us if there's a flashing light someplace here. But nothing's happening yet, so I'm going to power the actual system up. Then I'm going to go over to Pronarface. So inside Pronarface, we need to connect to this. Now I already know what the actual COM port is, so I'm going to connect. Now it says the printer is online. So I'm going to first try and move the X-axis to see what happens. So it looks like it's moving. So let's try homing it. So it looks like it home fine. It looks like the homing bump didn't work though, but that's okay. We can go in and play with those settings some other time. But if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.